A lot of people have lost their jobs in the pandemic, and that was the case for Ivy Hotchkiss. She spent weeks looking online for a job and thought she found one working from home for this national women's clothing company.
Given the state of the economy at the time, I was ecstatic to have a job as a student where, you know, I wasn't making much at the time.
To work for the company, she was told she'd need specific office equipment. So she was sent a check for almost $3,500, told to e-transfer that money to an office furniture company. So she did, but it turns out it was all an elaborate scam. The real Aritzia had nothing to do with it. 2 days later, the check bounced.
Shock and disbelief, just clutching my computer thinking, what am I going to do?
Hotchkiss says she trusted the money was there because she saw the $3,500 in her account for 2 days and stay there until she e-transferred the money. According to the Canadian Anti-Fraud Centre, in the first 9 months of this year, almost 1,400 people have lost more than $8 million from job scams, often due to fake checks.
We're more connected to technology more than ever, working, being at home, being next to a computer. So this basically put a great foundation for scam artists to really to use in their model to try to trick people.
TD said it was Hotchkiss's fault for cashing a fake check, but did offer to put a hold on future checks until they've been verified.
I don't understand why this isn't a regular policy for every customer. This would prevent everyone from being scammed.
This law prof says, given the increased scams, the banks need to do more to protect people.
This could have been easily resolved if the banks had just simply put a hold on the check until it cleared. But they just don't make that feature available because it doesn't make them money.
After GoPublic contacted TD Bank, it gave Ivy Hotchkiss back her $3,500 as a goodwill gesture and sent her a link with tips for avoiding job scams.